Hello everyone. Today I have come up with a topic, introduction, that is self-introduction. When you go to the interviews, when you talk to the people, and when you want to express about yourself, the self-introduction makes a lot of difference. When you go to interview, almost 95 to 99% you get this first question, that is introduce yourself, speak about yourself, how to speak. So most of the people will speak about their personal life, my father, mother, and then my education, qualification, school life, intermediate and all these things which are not much required. You have to speak qualitatively. 1 minute to 2 minutes you have to cover up this topic. You may be having a doubt that suppose I have written all my details in my resume or CV, but still why should I introduce myself? The reason is that recruiters want to see your confidence levels. Recruiters want to see how do you introduce yourself, what are the qualities you are having, how do you express yourself, how do you communicate yourself, and how do you use the body language. All these things they want to see, and it is also a warm-up question to introduce yourself. In between they'll see your resume and what are your qualities and what are the questions to be asked, they'll be preparing. That's the reason most of the time they'll ask you to introduce yourself. So for introduction of yourself, please remember few things. I am expressing here total 8 points. These 8 points you can take and you can mix it up anything else you want. Basically these points if you cover up, that will be the perfect self-introduction. So when you enter into the interview hall, the moment when interviewer asks that, introduce yourself. First say that, thank you very much sir for giving this opportunity to introduce myself. Or otherwise, it's my pleasure to introduce myself. Or otherwise, thank you very much for recruiting me or for giving me an opportunity to be interviewed. Anything you can say. Or thank you very much for shortlisting me for the personal interview. Like first you have to say thank you, then come to your introduction, self-introduction. So in self-introduction the first point is that take your name. So how do you take your name? So for taking your name there are different places. Some people say that myself, my name is, I am, this is, all these phrases are available. Myself is, it's for the highly qualified and highly educated people who are in a very good position, these people will use this myself. I am is totally, grammatically it is wrong. Don't use I am. And this is also not acceptable. This is fan, this is table, this is camera and this is pen and this is Devika Bhatnagar. It looks like that. So this is also no. So what you can use it always, my name is. My name is Sheila, my name is Swati, my name is Kiran, whatever may be your name, use the phrase of my name is. Then after that immediately talk about your place. You are from which place? What is your native place? I belong to New Delhi, or I belong to Jaipur, or you can say, I'm a native of India's capital New Delhi. I'm a native of Pearl City, Hyderabad. Like, speak about your only place, not much details. Then after that, education qualifications. When you want to talk about education qualifications, please remember that all your education qualifications are not required. Most of the people will speak that intermediate, degree and PG, 10th class also they'll speak. Of course, you have completed your 10th class, intermediate and all these things, then you have entered into the PG level. That is why always speak your education qualifications, only the highest education qualification. Highest, along with highest education qualification, if you have anything else, you have done a crash course, you have done a diploma, what else you have done? So all these things also you can add up here. If you are pursuing your BTech or MBA, MCA, anything, you can say that's your highest qualification. Presently, I am pursuing my MBA from so-and-so college, or BTech or MTech from so-and-so college. Pursuing, you can say, otherwise, I am a postgraduate, or I am a graduate, I am having the qualification, something you can speak. Along with that, any other crash courses, diplomas, whatever you have done, that also you add up. That gives a weightage for your introduction. That's the difference between you and other candidates. So speak about your education qualifications, only highest, and any other crash courses, diplomas you have done. And next one is that coming to achievements. You can speak about your achievements. What kind of achievements you are having? Speak in two ways. One is professional achievements, another one is personal achievements. Professional achievements are related to the career point of view. Your academic career point of view, what are your achievements? You were the topper in the college, you got distinction, you got a medal, and you have participated in a national level seminar and you got the prize or you gave a paper presentation. Anything related to the academic track point of view. So those are, you can say it as the professional achievements. But during your work, if you have an experience, during your work also, whatever you have achievements, you got awards, rewards, and you got so and so increments, and any appreciations, any medals, any milestones in your career, those things comes under the professional achievements. Then personal achievements. Personal achievements, you can say, any kind of achievements related to the co-curricular activities, sports, martial arts, yoga, music, dance, meditation, anything. If you have done any kind of achievement, you got award or reward, and you have done diploma, you have completed a course, or you are having a black belt in karate, or anything that comes under the personal. Personal achievements also you must mention, because it shows that you are an all-rounder. So that is why speak about your personal achievements. Please remember, sometimes you will be thinking that I don't have any achievements. Remember, recollect it, ask your parents, ask your sibling, ask your friends, ask your teacher. Some achievements are there for you that you need to mention, you need to share with the recruiters. Then after that, experience and project work. Experience / project work, I say. If you have experience, say it wonderfully, say it excellently, describe your experience. How do you describe? Say your experience, I'm having 5 years of experience, rich experience in so-and-so organization at the so-and-so position, and my work, my target, and I'm good, and I'm expertised, my key areas, and these are the areas what I have done because of my work, organization got so-and-so benefits, and I got award, and because of me, organization is in so-and-so position. Like, you speak about your experience and your work, nature of work, where you have done, what you have done, your area of interest, describe in more elaborate way. That makes definite difference to your introduction. And also you can say you worked as a member and you worked as a team member, or otherwise you were a leader and you have guided so-and-so people, you are having the leadership qualities, and what else you have done, just described in detail. So that's about experience. If you don't have experience, then speak about the project work. If you don't have experience, project work also you can consider it as the experience. But once if you have experience, no need of project work. That's the reason, select either this or this, experience or project work. If you are a fresher, no experience, rather than saying, no, I don't have experience, you can say that, I have done my project work in so-and-so company on so-and-so aspect, and my outcome, my target, my suggestions, whatever you got it, all these things you can share in 4 or 5 sentences perfectly, actively, and you must express that you have knowledge, you have done, so that you can speak, either experience or project work. Next one is strengths. What are the strengths? Strengths will reveal your professional quality. So speak about your strengths, only professional strengths, not personal. Professional strengths. Personal strengths means, one candidate said, 12 o'clock night, I can spend my time in burial ground alone. This is my strength, but it is personal. What to do with the company? No. So that is why speak about professional strengths only. Professional strengths are those strengths which adds asset, which gives, which enhances the quality of the organization, which will be useful for the organization. Like, I'm very hardworking and I'm sincere and I'm very much committed and I can work independently, I'm a quick learner, and anything else. I have a leadership qualities and I'm a workaholic. These kind of things you can say it as a strength, professional strength. Think it, what is your strength? Just think it and use good words. Take it from dictionary and apply to your life, and then say that this is my strength, I am committed. Apply and say that difference, you will find it, and recruiters also will find it. So that's about the strengths. Then after that, hobbies. Hobbies will reflect your personality. So what kind of hobbies you are having? Say that your hobbies are something different, reading newspaper and watching news channels and cooking, gardening, sports, music, games, anything. This kind of hobbies you can say. But please remember, based on your hobbies, you will have questions, counter questions. Must be ready to answer these questions. So select your hobbies very carefully. And lastly, speak about your ambition. What is your ambition? Don't say simply that I want to become a manager, I want to become entrepreneur simply. Don't speak like that. Speak about your ambition in two ways. One is short-term ambition, then long-term. Presently, I want to get a job. I want to settle down myself in any good organization where it will give me a platform, where it will give me a kind of a good thing where I can start my work, like you can speak. And long term, in long term I wanted to settle down, or after 2 years, after 5 years I want to see myself in so and so position, after 10 years I want to be the backbone of any organization, I want to be the asset of any organization, or after 15 years I want to start my own business, I want to become an entrepreneur. Like, what do you have? That you must mention, that this is my ambition. So these are the things, these are the points which you can speak in your self-introduction. Please remember, all these points I have given you only to have how to speak, what are the things to be speak. If you by heart these points, if you speak in the same sequence, your self-introduction will be like this. Good morning ma'am, thank you very much for giving this opportunity. My name is so-and-so, I'm from so-and-so area and coming to my education qualifications and my achievements. Like, you know, you are by-hearted and you speak like this. So never by heart this. Write a good sentences, take pen and paper and start writing your introduction. Use good words, good sentences, vocabulary, and what are your skills. It should be naturally you are explaining about yourself. In that way, you can practice it. Please remember, my dear students, self-introduction is very important. You just practice it, write down the notes, then after that, you can just rehearsal it. Then after that, record your voice. In the next stage, you can record your self-introduction in cell phone. Then see how you are speaking. Is it acceptable? As a recruiter, how he is going to accept it? Imagine in the place of recruiter, how it is. Is there any changes are needed? How is your body language? All these things. So this is what your self-introduction. Hope this talk is useful for you. Make use of this and prepare yourself. In the coming videos, I'm going to speak a lot of things related to your career and job skills point of view. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. I'm giving you downside of this video, a lot of playlist. I prepared communication body language point of view, a lot of videos. That playlist is there. And interviews, group discussions, a lot of playlists are there. Please find it, make use of it. Wish you good luck. Take care. Keep smiling. Keep shining.